What is up, guys? ShadowXRY here, coming at you with a brand new video. Gonna be showing you guys how to install Guess Who mod on a... It's not really a mod, it's a map on a server. So if you've seen me, Bidge, and Canadian, any other Minecraft YouTubers play it, that's what I'm gonna sort of do. So what you're gonna need to do, I'll have all the links that you're gonna need for this in the description of the video. So first, you're gonna need to download Minecraft Server 1.8-pre3. That will be in the description. And then I'll have the Guess Who version 1.5 mod. They're coming out with a 2.0 version, so that'll be pretty awesome. I can't wait to see that. I'll have another update video, and I can probably link it to this one. Link this one to that new one. Yeah. So, let me just show you. This will take you to the 1.8 pre-release. It's a Mojang site, so you know it's safe, because obviously Mojang wouldn't want to, you know, put bugs in it or viruses and whatever in there. So you're just going to come here and scroll down. It'll right away take you to this page. You're going to want to scroll all the way down. You can read all this stuff if you want to know what's going to be in it, but I already did that. So then you want to scroll down, and right where it says cross-platform server jar, you want to click on this. It's going to download. Put that on your desktop. Then once you do that, it'll be right here. All right, you're good with that then. Now, get your Guess Who mod. Put that on your desktop, all right? So go to the either first or second. I don't know which order I'm going to have in. It'll be in the description, easy to find. Click on that. It'll take you to this. Wonder where you download it from. Oh, maybe this nice big download button. Click that. If you want to see screenshots of everything, you can. It's pretty easy. Some of the stuff doesn't work. There's a little bit of bugs, tweaking, but that's all right. Everything still works great. It really tells you how to do it, so it's not that hard, but I didn't see many videos up on YouTube of it, so I was like, you know what? Let's do it. It tells you the instructions. It'll also tell you the instructions in the game, so that's good. What you're going to also... I'll show you what you need to do but download this right here, and it'll either take you to AdFly or something like that. Just download that. It's safe. I promise you, I've already done this. This is the only one. This is like the only way... place you download it. You click download here, it takes you who knows where, ZapCloud I guess, and then hit download now. It'll take you to AdFly or something like that, but this description will be in the description below. So once that's on your desktop, first thing you want to do, right click, new folder, and I'm just gonna call this server tut, and yeah, we'll just call it that. Once you have that, what you're going to want to do is put your Minecraft server 1.8 pre-release into that, and then once that's in there, you're going to double click it and run it, and I'll show you what that does. It's going to load up like a normal server should, obviously. Give it some time. Then I'm just going to show you this. What it means, you need to agree to the Eula in order to run the server. So it tells you what to do. Go to the Eula.txt for more info. Okay, obvious. Let's just exit out of that then. Where's that? Oh, the Eula.txt. There we go. Let's read this. By changing the settings below to true, you are indicating your agreement between our Eula account.mojang. Whatever. I didn't read that. If you want to go for it, go for it. It's probably something stupid anyway. They don't really make these for the older versions. So, I don't know. But, change it to true. It'll be false. Change it to true like I just did. File. Save. If you don't hit file save and you just exit out, it will not stick and you will keep getting an error. So, make sure you do that. Once you do that, exit out of it. Run it again. Let it load up. There we go. Alright, it's going to load up, put all this stuff in here for you. You're going to wait till it prepares all the spawn area for you, because once it does that, then you'll be good to go. So we're just going to sit here and let that go for a little bit. Hmm. Any day now. It's just gonna take time because it has to load up. That's what it's doing right now, is loading up a world, so just give it time. And done. Alright, so then we'll just hit stop. Stop. And close out of that. Once you do that, you're gonna have something that should look like a normal server, pretty much, obviously. Go to server. Once you're in your notepad for server and you double click, if it doesn't open up in some kind of notepad, then what you're going to want to do, if it doesn't open up like that, then obviously yours won't open up. You're going to right click, open with, and you can choose. Obviously, if this was your first time, it may be on something really weird like Internet Explorer. Just click, keep using notepad or WordPad. Any of that stuff works. I like notepad. I think it works best. So, yeah, we're just going to use that. Then, all the stuff, this is how you change everything in your server. If you're going to be using this for guess who, you're going to need to do this. You're going to need to go down to command block, and that equals false, which means command blocks will not work. Guess who is all about command blocks. You need to change it to true. Change it to true, and then once you do that, let me look for it. Server IP. If you don't know your IPv4, address, what you're gonna wanna do is go to search, and then however you search, I'm on Windows 8, so I'm just gonna go to cmd command, my command prompt, click on that, it's gonna come up here, type in ipconfig. You guys see it? All one word, there's no spaces, no space right after here. It's type in ipconfig, enter. It'll take you to all this stuff. Alright, scroll. I'm just going to scroll all the way to the top to where I typed it in. Blah, 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 blah. IPv4 address, dot, 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 followed across 192.168.1.8. That is nothing you can, I mean, that's why I'm showing it, is because it's not important. All it is what your computer's address is, pretty much. So your computer, that's how your computer connects to your Wi-Fi. So if you were curious about that, that's what it is. You need to take that. I already remember mine, so I'm just gonna, you don't need this anymore. Once you know that, you're good. Now, if you need help on port forwarding and port triggering and how to do all that, and forward triggering and all that, let me know. I can definitely do a video on that. You guys just need to let me know. But I'm just gonna exit out of that because I memorized mine already. So it's 192.168.1.8. Type that into the server IP. You can change even more stuff if you'd like. That's up to you. I don't really need to change anything else. Nothing else is really messed up. So hit save. If you don't hit save, none of this will save, obviously, and it will not work with loading guess who. So exit out of that now. And once you've done that, your server is up and running and good to go. Now, you need to get rid of world here. Delete that. And now it's time for the guess who. All right, you got your server tucked. Double click. You're going to need some type of 7-zip opener. I use WinRAR. I've always have. I think it makes more sense. I think it's easier than 7-zip. It just makes more sense. I like it better. I will have in the description WinRAR for you to download. So you can go do that. I'm still on the free trial, and the free trial never runs out. Well, it runs out, but you can still use it. As you saw, the thing popped up. Just hit X, and it's fine. And then once you open it up, it has a version for Mac users. And then it has a version that says, guess who, version 1.5. This is what Windows users are going to use. Obviously, I'm a Windows user, so I'm going to drag that over here. Put that on my desktop. As you see, it's right there. I don't need this anymore. X out of that. Now, see your guess who? If I put this right in here right now like that, and I ran my server, that would not run at all. I would get something that says it's going to like crash, or maybe it might just automatically crash. What you need to do, just take that out real quick, and just so you guys can see that better. Take it out. What you're going to need to do, double click on it. In here, what you need to do, boom. Highlight it all. Cut. New. World. All lowercase. All right. No caps. Enter. Right click on that. paste, boom. Everything is in here. Now, for this world, each time you play it, listen to me, this is a must. I figured this out all myself. Each time you play the world, so say right now this would not work, because see this players is here. You need to right click on the players, delete that. Alright, once you do that, you are good to go. Put this version, copy it right on over to your server, tut, paste it, and you will be good to play in here. You might fall out of the world a couple times, it'll eventually put you in the starting thing. That's fine, that's normal, it'll probably do that for me once I show you guys. And see, now I don't have players in my world, which if you do have players in there and you forget to do that, it'll most likely on your, once you double click this and run this, like it'll say detected error, if it'll say this stuff and whatnot, or world users, or it remembers other people's worlds and users, then it says if the problem persists, make sure you go to your world and players and get rid of players, and then you'll be good to go. So I'm just gonna quick here opt myself. You need to also be opt. If you're not gonna read this stuff and you're just gonna watch my video, it will not work. None of the command blocks will not work unless both people are opt. So you need to opt you and whoever else is coming into your server. That be a friend, a brother, whoever, I don't care. But opt yourself, then you need to just load up Minecraft, and I'll show you here. Give it a sec. Which, do I have two of them up? I don't know, it's just that. Alright. What you're gonna wanna do is whatever you're on, yours, unless you have this checked, this might not work. So you're gonna have to click snapshots, just click on enable experimental development versions. Snapshots, obviously. That's a server you just made, is a snapshot server. Alright, click on that. Are you sure you want to enable the development builds? They are not guaranteed. So if you're putting a world that you spent a year, 2 years, I don't care, your entire life on, and you put it in here, what they're saying is it could get corrupted and your world could get fucked over for good. So that's pretty much what it's saying. So obviously have backups of that if you're one of those people. I'm not. But are you sure you wish to continue? Yes. And then what you're going to do is it'll add a bunch of new things in here. As you see, snapshot. Scroll all the way up to the top to snapshot 1.8 pre-3 and hit save profile, play, and it'll play. Let it download that. If that's your first time, it'll probably take a little bit longer to download, but let that do that and give it a sec. It'll load up Minecraft 1.8 pre-3, which is the server that you just made. As you see, look, 1.8 pre-3. Wow, isn't that a coincidence that it's the same? Go. I already have my server on here, that my servers all run the same thing. So if I'm running, I don't know, my bucket server, a vanilla server for something, a lucky block server, any kind of server I'm running, it is going to run on the same IPv4, so because if you're running it from your computer. If you're running it from a different computer, it'll run from a different computer. So pretty obvious. I mean, just if it doesn't show up, refresh, and then I don't know, then you didn't do something right, or you don't have your port forwarding, port triggering, and that is a must. This will not work if you don't have your port forwarding or port triggering. If you need to do that, if you need help on that, I'd be more than happy to go and do a tutorial, but I'm gonna hop in on my server real quick and show you guys what it looks like. Gonna load it up. And like, oh, I got lucky for once. Usually you fall down, and if you do, you're just gonna, oh, it's a little laggy at first. Give it a sec. It's because I'm also doing a bunch of stuff right now. Just do slash, if you're out here, just do slash game mode uno, which is one, and fly up here, and it'll take you to all this stuff. You can read the rules, but I already, you can do that other places too. If you need to do that. Then once you and your friend are both in here, you're both opt, start the game, right click on the button, it'll take you to this. And then as you see, it says your head right here. And when you're it, like when you're playing, if it's your turn, ask, and it should give you a axe. There it is, the headbreaker, as they call it. Yeah, headbreaker, I'm breaking. So, doesn't break anything but heads, I see. So, yeah, and then you guys ask questions, or you can guess. The guessing doesn't really work. Don't know why. Even when you click guess, it doesn't really work. Maybe that's just something I have messed up. But, yeah, that's how to do it. And then once you guys get down to the very bottom, obviously, you know, that's how it's going to do. And sometimes that does that. It just does that. It did that because I didn't have another person in there with me. That's why, because it recognized that you need two people. You don't have two people, it's not going to work, obviously. So, just waiting for that to happen. So, yeah. If you guys enjoyed and this helps you a lot, make sure you hit that like button. Subscribe to me. Follow my Twitch. Favorite this. Comment on it. Let me know if there's something else you'd like me to do. And I will see you later, guys. Bye!